Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. This week, we've got teams who went in opposite directions last week. With that, it's time to hook up with our commentators in the booth as we turn it over to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Larry, first opened in 2006. Here's a look inside University of Phoenix Stadium in Glendale, Arizona. It's certainly hot outside here in the desert, but somehow this Cardinal crowd turned up the heat a moment ago. They were in a frenzy as their team emerged from the tunnel, and the Cardinals, they're set to do battle with the Seattle Seahawks. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden. Charles, you look at this Cardinal team as they get ready here. They were winners last time out, so they'll be looking, Charles, to make it two in a row.
And what I enjoyed when I watched their game tape and their victory last week is they put it together in every phase. Good offense, good defense, and some key plays on special teams. Let's see if they can get that second win in a row.
And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. Meanwhile, for our visitors, the Seahawks. A man under center for this Seattle offense, Russell Wilson, as they take the field. He put the ball in the air 45 times last week, but it was in a loss to Washington. How did you assess his play?
Normal Russell Wilson in so many ways, but the pressure that Washington's defensive front seven put on him, couldn't hang in the pocket, had to flush a lot and try and beat Russell Wilson to make these creative plays, but the coverage downfield was excellent by Washington. Very hard for him to find open receivers.
And he did throw two interceptions. And this offense often hinges on one of the best tight ends in the league, and that's Jimmy Graham.
I think he made up for lost time when he got to the NFL because in college, he was mainly a basketball player, a defender who couldn't score. Now he's flipped it around in the NFL. Every time he touches the ball, he's a threat to score.
Again on second and 10, it's Wilson eluding the pressure right. Room here to run. They showed off the athletic juke. Good little gain there, not a whole lot of real estate, but a nice carry. And give him 10 that time as he was able to get away from the pressure and get a nice gain.
You know, I don't think this is the last time we'll see that in this game. This guy has mobility, and they want to use his legs in the game plan. So there'll be design runs as well as his scrambles.
And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs. Now Wilson on first down. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down. So a look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field. They tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
No excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization. The key is having guys on the roster who are capable of filling in and playing at a high level. That's when you know you've drafted well, scouted free agents well, and stocked your team just the way you're supposed to.
A really good pickup of 28 yards. First down, this is Rawls. He winds up getting only a couple there, down to the 29. Let's see what the offense comes with here, second and 8. From the gun, it's Wilson. And he will find his man on the outside. And he's brought down. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
And the 8th play on this drive coming up. Now Wilson on second down. Steps away to his left. And I think the ball's out.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Now it's Wilson. And he whips that one incomplete there.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. On second down, rolls. And this time he's going backwards. So after the no gain on the last attempt, here they get him behind the line.
Yes, indeed. That play there, that reminds me of some of the guys that I played with that have that suddenness, able to get into the backfield almost about the time the ball snapped and make a play. How about that tackle for a loss?
Absolutely. He did a lot of that last week when he was named the NFC Defensive Player of the Week. One of the guys on the team was saying, yeah, we called him the disruptor, and that's carrying forward again.
Makes sense, doesn't it? They may be snapping the ball near the goal line, but all you're thinking defensively, keep them out of the end zone. Force the incompletion. Force him into going for three and not giving up six.
And Walsh able to convert it as his kick is good. And the Seahawks grab a 3-0 lead. So they get three. They were hoping for six. An unlucky number 13 play drive.
Well, you go to the sideline after putting 3 points on the board, happy. But you wanted to be ecstatic. You wanted to have six on the board. On the opposite sideline, though, the defense, I think they're high-fiving each other, only giving up three after letting them run that much offense.
And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. In his 11th NFL season, Drew Stanton will bring out the Arizona offense. And last week's, I mentioned 11th season, just his 14th career start with Palmer out. They got the win, though.
They certainly did. He's 15-30, 201 yards, two touchdowns, the interception. The receivers trust him, but above all, his head coach Bruce Arians trusts him, knows the offense. He's a tough, gritty type of a player.
A first carry now for Adrian Peterson. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. That'll set him back with a loss of three on the play. And it'll bring up a second and 13.
Okay, let's just make this one simple. We know that the running game is not their thing, but they can't just throw it on every single down without expecting some real heat from the pass rush.
Defense in a good spot. Let's see how the offense responds with a second and 13 now. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Stanton. And he'll get nothing out of that one. No gain on the play, and it'll bring up a third down. Let's look at this offense now, and let's talk about John Brown.
An exciting young talent from Pittsburgh State, home of the Gorillas. Hard to cover, great moves in short areas.
And with a third and 13 here, the defense in a dime look. From the gun, Stanton. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds, so a big call there that brings up fourth.
Trust me, Brandon, I'm not about to try and take your job. I can't do what you do. But that wasn't just three and out. That felt like three and backwards.
That's exactly what it was. You can have my job whenever you want it. The drive that you're looking for, though, probably going forward, bad start to the ball game.
Yeah, not the way to get things going.
Here's the veteran punter Lee as he sends this one away. Returnable for Lockett. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And it'll be Seahawk football first and 10. Well, let's go league-wide before this next drive starts. Last week, we discussed some of the trades that happened. Jay Ajayi did look pretty good in a Philly uniform, long touchdown run.
Boy, they really made a great deal to get him, and now they compare him with LeGarrette Blount, and he kind of got a thunder-lightning type thing. And Ajayi showed some lightning against Denver. But how about this? Kelvin Benjamin went, but on a Thursday night game, not enough time to get him ready to play for his new team in Buffalo. Jimmy Garoppolo did not play with San Francisco. We'll find out when they both will get on the field. And how about the Saints and the the Cardinals. Because remember, the Adrian Peterson trade, I think it benefited both teams.
Yeah, AP went over 100 yards. Kamara and Ingram, they really settled in as well. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Now the offense lining up first and 10. From the shotgun, Wilson. And this will be incomplete.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of, otherwise he was going to get sacked.
They'll come up now with the clock showing 3 seconds to go here in the first. Second and 10. It's Wilson again. That will be incomplete. They couldn't hook up on what's going to be the final play of this first quarter. One quarter in the books here on a Thursday night. 3-0 is our score. Back to Glendale after this timeout.
The NFL on EA Sports is presented by Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Alongside my broadcast partner, Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden hits the Seahawks with a football to begin quarter number two. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. They go play action now. Wilson escaping the pressure. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Hassan Reddick, the rookie from Temple. And it'll be fourth down.
This Cardinals pass rush in 2016 got home 48 times. That's a pretty good number.
A very good number. Led the league. Is it just because the dudes that they had or the scheme or both or what?
It's always the dudes first. But their scheme, attacking, pressure, they'll continue to pile up the sacks.
33 yards is the distance on the punt there. And the Cards will take over first and 10. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Partner, you mind if I take off this headset and put on a coaching headset?
You want to get this running game going?
I want to get this running game going. I'm going down there and saying, gentlemen, we have got to run the football. We've got to get it going right now.
Yeah, to this point in the second quarter, it has been a struggle. Again with Peterson. And he's got some space here. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. All told, it's an even 30 and a first down. With that last carry, Adrian Peterson has gone over 12,000 yards in his career. He becomes the 16th member of that elusive club.
How about that? The next three guys that are on the list that he can pass, all Hall of Famers. Thurman Thomas, Franco Harris, and Marcus Allen. No wonder his dad called him AD for all day. That man can go.
Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
Oh, the rookie nearly had the pick. Probably should have had it. Third down now.
The one thing that I've liked defensively is that they're showing them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. That'll go as a loss of 5. And that's going to make it third down and 10. Operating from the gun, Stanton. And Gresham has it left side. And they do stop him, but he takes it all the way to the two. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
As we continue to advance in the NFL, as people continue to scout players, they really don't care as much about body types as they care about those guys who can make people miss, run through tackles, and gain all that additional run after catch. Anybody who has that ability, they want them on their team.
They'll run with Peterson, and he will get into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Adrian Peterson, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Cardinals are in for six. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how we're going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And still a lot of football to be played in this season. We're only in November. A lot can happen between now and January. But if it ended today, they would just be on the outside of the playoff picture looking in. So a lot to fight for.
Yeah, and wasn't it interesting in our meeting with the coaching staff that they all made sure to let us know. We know where we are right now. But the playoffs don't start tomorrow. We still got some time, and they plan on putting it together, formulating a streak, and the whole month of December is still left to play. They think they can get in.
And they made it very obvious to us that there's no playoff talk in the locker room right now. It's win this game and look to next week.
Excellent focus.
We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Larry Ridley in Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report. On second down, here's Wilson. And a grab made by Doug Baldwin. 20, 10, 5, and all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Doug Baldwin, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Seahawks get the quick strike touchdown.
I think if you pulled defensive backs, they would say the corner route, take that out, make it illegal, because that is so hard to recognize and so hard to adjust, because your first move is to not get beat in the middle of the field. And that's how they move you first before they break off to the corner.
But then as the wide receiver, great job. It's tough to turn those upfield and go, but he did a great job with it there.
Really good balance, really good body control. And how about the end result? A touchdown.
Here's Walsh now to kick this one off. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. So out now come the Cardinals. That last drive, it was a good mix. Run, pass, run, pass. Defense on their toes.
And what really helps out in a big way is when you're doing the run-pass mix and everything's working, that means that they're guessing wrong every time on defense. They think you're going to pass when you run and vice versa. I would continue that, and when they finally draw a bead on you, maybe you mix it up a little bit, a little play action, and throw the ball.
And will they maintain that balance? Time to find out. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. To throw again, Stanton, and Gresham's got it over the middle, and they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They give him 14 yards that time, and a fresh set of downs. Now Stanton, throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. That one was intended for John Brown. That'll bring up second down. And guess what? That incompletion gives me a chance to ask you who your MVP is in NFL right
really?
Now. Who are you going with?
Well, there's so many different choices, right? Tom Brady's a perennial, and you can never go wrong with him, and he's still rallying New England.
He's got too many trophies. Give me somebody else.
Look at you. You can't zing him for that. But listen, to me, it comes down to Carson Wentz in Philadelphia having an extraordinary second season, and what Alex Smith is doing in Kansas City cannot be overestimated right now. And I'm going to go with Alex Smith, because head-to-head, his Kansas City Chiefs beat the Philadelphia Eagles.
That's true. If the Eagles, though, 8-1 right now, should be interesting to watch the rest of the way.
Sounds like you're making a case for Carson Wentz.
I am. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Seahawks, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Let's start on the ground with Rawls. And an alley to run. There goes Thomas Rawls. He's at the 50. 30, the 20, 10, and all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Thomas Rawls, his first touchdown on the year. And the Seahawks get the quick strike touchdown. And with that carry, he's already over 100 yards here in the first half.
And partner, you know exactly what he's saying to his teammates right now, right? Especially to the play caller.
Give me the ball.
Again and again, and again. It's not that heavy, sir. I'll take it.
It's good to make it 17-7. Here's Walsh now to kick this one off. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Getting set to go again. We get a peek at Larry Fitzgerald as he heads back out there now. A chance maybe here for them to get him more involved. They're down here on the scoreboard, and he's been very quiet.
And the silence has been deafening for his team. They don't need that at all. They need fireworks. They need explosive plays. They need him touching the football in any way possible. Maybe go to some jet sweeps. Anything to get him going.
There's something to get in the ball. We'll see if they can do it. And he'll go out of bounds across the 35-yard line. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
Anytime you call man coverage against Larry Fitzgerald, you're really holding your breath as a defensive guy, because his ability to run such precise routes and use that big frame that he has, that body against you, it's going to be very difficult to break passes up against him.
Yeah, when you make 9 Pro Bowls in your first 12 years, you might want to give him a little bit more coverage than that.
Yeah, it's not just athletic ability. He's a thinking man's receiver as well.
Looking to throw, Stanton, and it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Throwing again on second and 10. Stanton, it's brought incomplete. It's John Brown. And a stoppage here, a timeout before this third down play takes place. As the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number 2. From the gun on third down, Stanton over the middle. John Brown's got it. Now the Cardinals going to call another timeout, their second, as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. On first and 10, Stanton. And this is caught on the left side, Jerron Brown. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. That throw good for 4. It's second down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
A final shot before break. Stanton caught on the left side. Fitzgerald. And with a clock reading zeros, he is into the end zone. What an exclamation mark to the end of this second quarter.
Indeed. Indeed. But my education continues in this game, I've got to tell you, because there's not an analyst in the world that would have said pass up the field goal here, go for it, and expect for it to be successful. And it was. I mean, they're playing this one just like a video game.
Well, Larry, I know it's late there in Orlando. This is a school night. Folks eager to get right back to the action here in the third quarter. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This fielded at the two. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. So here's the Cardinals offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. Jaron Brown, the intended target, and that'll bring up second down. Well, with that pass going awry, Charles, I hate to discuss this, but we need to. Deshaun Watson goes down with an injury, ACL tear done for the season, and boy, that's tough.
It is extremely tough, especially when we do everything possible to protect players in practice, to make sure you have good practices, no injuries, and it just happened on a routine, normal play. And when he gets back, he will make the same exact movements again. Just a freak injury, and now the Texans, that's going to be tough. The number one scoring offense with him, they really struggled against Indianapolis Colts.
Yeah, they did. Just 14 points. Really nice response from Watson, though, saying he's going to come back stronger than ever.
And how about the response from the league? How about the respect he garnered in his short time as the quarterback?
Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. Shift together here from the D-line. Now a play fake here on first down. And he finds a man on the crossing route. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one, and that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little gain. And this time the yards won't come so easy as they'll in fact tackle him behind the line.
I think it's pretty evident we can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. So it can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Well, you know a coach said that, right? Yeah. Not an actual player, not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
And brought down, but the juke, the very nice juke, gives him the first down yardage there. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. So the offense has it first and 10. To throw. Stanton. The swing pass caught. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. John Brown. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Cardinals are in for six. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions, and I'd hear 9, from the receivers. That meant fly route, go. Look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
Oh, and now he bowls him over. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Second down, Wilson. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
So how do you beat man coverage? First of all, you want to be a superior receiver, but you know something, that guy who's covering you, he's usually pretty good too. So the corner route is usually a great spot to get it done.
Down with Wilson. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Richardson. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
Again, Wilson, flush to his right, and his throw is incomplete. The intended target, Doug Baldwin, at his third and short. Well, too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
Yeah, really turned it loose, didn't he? Really cut loose with that one, sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
So third and two, this quite possibly four down territory, though, if they're stopped. There's Wilson to throw, and incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Perhaps they overthought this one a little bit. They've been running it real well on this drive, and it was third and short, okay? They decided to throw the football incomplete. Yeah, they might have thought just a little bit too hard about that play selection.
They're going on fourth down. It's Wilson. Flushed out right. He may try and run for this. Give him 7 on the tuck and run, and it'll get him a new set of downs. They're going to hurry back to the line now. On first down, Wilson. Complete. Richardson has it. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Now it's Wilson. Evades him at the 10. And he's caught right at the 10-yard line. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 to the 5-yard line. So there on that play, offensively, they ran the crossing route. Defense was in zone coverage. So as a former DB, how tough is it to defend that?
It's really difficult because...
And he will not be denied. Into the end zone. Touchdown, Seahawks. Thomas Rawls with 2 touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Seahawks are able to strike for 6. He's given him a little jolt, just gave him the lead there, but 2 TDs now in the game.
And that jolt puts them in the lead. What a terrific job by him. He is carrying the ball and simply saying, I want to win.
And now he's hoping his defense has that mentality as they try to hang on to that lead. One quarter remains here in this Thursday night matchup. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Back now here on EA Sports. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point, just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. Here's Walsh now to kick this one off. This is fielded at the goal line. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. The Cardinal offense here ready to take over. Both teams working on short rest, but this has been one of the better Thursday night games we've seen as they come up here on first and 10. Throwing to start the drive. Stanton lets it go for Nelson. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
Well, I guess we just discovered that someone is certainly not going to sit back and just take it in this game, huh?
No, they were trying to get that touchdown back in one shot.
One shot, trying to help out his defense and let the other team know they were coming after him.
Throwing again. Stanton over the middle here to Brown. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it. So it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Looking to throw. Stanton. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. He was trying to get it to AP out of the backfield. And it's second down. And not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it. And he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. The tight end, Jermaine Gresham, the intended receiver. And now it's third down.
You know, every time we talk with people about the most important quality for a quarterback to have in the NFL, what do they usually cite?
Arm strength.
Yeah, and that's really way down on the list. Accuracy is one of the bigger ones, maybe the foremost one. That's what he needed on that play.
Off play action. Stanton. Pressure comes. He's taken down by the Seahawk defense. K.J. Wright with a big-time sack on third down. And it'll be a loss of 7. And that'll be marked down as their first sack of the game.
Well, they had 6 last week. And this offense did its homework, didn't it? Because they saw all that pressure, and they really worked hard to tamp it down and beat it back. And they did a great job in the first half. But now they've gotten their first sack here in the second half. Look out. They'll try to increase the pressure.
As Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And we have seen a lot on the scoreboard here in this quarter. So sometimes you talk to me about tendency breakers on offense. These defenses struggling. Are there tendency breakers on defense?
All defensive coordinators keep something in their hip pocket for these types of situations. What can we do to slow down the onslaught? But the biggest thing is make sure these guys encourage each other, pick themselves up, because right now, it's been a really tough ball game trying to stop these offense.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Chandler Jones in there to get him. And that's sack number 12 for him on the year. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Quarterback gets hit.
He's going to air this. He's got a man complete. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. On first down, Procise. And he's brought down. 11 more on that one and another first down.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there. And on that play, I saw a defense staying in base, not taking a chance, not blitzing in a situation where they absolutely need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it but not thinking it through.
If you do blitz, do you have to be careful about where you're coming from, or are you just coming from all angles?
You have to be careful about where you're coming from, obviously, but at this stage, you have to take a few chances as well.
Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down, stomped down. How about that? Back-to-back completions, they are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. So what will they do? On the ground, through the air, let's see. Second and nine. They go again with Rawls. And able to work his way down to the 16. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. The Seahawks on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. They're up against a third and one situation. They run with a power back, Rawls. And now running right through it. And they'll lose yardage here. Knocked back to the 19-yard line. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left. So a big spot forthcoming for the kicker, Blair Walsh. From the left hash, it's a 36-yard attempt. And Walsh able to convert it as his kick is good. And the drive will wind up yielding 3. So they get the 3 here, but you wonder whether that's going to be enough.
Yeah, I mean, you've now made it so they need a touchdown rather than a field goal to catch them. But you're right. If they'd gotten 6 out of that drive, this would be a much different game.
Oh, and now he bowls him over. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. They'll look to throw. He's going to let it. It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, Cardinals! Larry Fitzgerald with his second touchdown of the game and 5th on the year. And the Cardinals are an extra point away from taking the lead.
I don't think there's any great secret or mystery here. We're in the fourth quarter. You've got to take that shot, especially since you're down on the scoreboard. But I have to understand what was going on defensively. They've got to know that as well, don't they?
Absolutely, but they look lost defensively, and they took that shot, got in the end zone, now in position here to take the lead. Pretty clean and simple there. Just 2 plays, the long pass resulting in the touchdown on play number 2. This fielded at the 2. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The Seahawks offense now, they get set to go back to work. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
Yeah, they practice this all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect.
It's a lot of contact going on there. And in the end, unable to keep 2 hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. Back to throw. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Thank you. The Seahawks on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is third and 10. He'll look to throw. And able to find Graham, complete. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. He got 29 yards that time. Back to throw. He'll lock it with a grab over the middle. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. Attempt carry for Thomas Rawls. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. Wilson trying to urge his guys to go faster and get set at the line. They stay on the ground. Rawls again. And effective running here. He'll take it down inside the 10. He's able to rattle off 6 on the carry, and that'll get him to 3rd and 4. In position for the possible game winner, but they need to get up and spike it. Third down. Here's Rawls. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a 4th down. And they're going to get the timeout called. What a finish. We're down to 4 seconds to go in this football game. So on now is Blair Walsh. 2 for 2 tonight. This will be for the win. And his kick is indeed good. And it's celebration time on that sideline as they have taken the lead in the final seconds. And Charles, he hasn't missed a kick all year. Why would he start now?
Exactly. And this was by far the most nerve-wracking. They just stepped up and calmly banged it through.
Now after the made field goal, Walsh back out to kick it away. Short kick. One of the up men will take it down. And they'll be set up with good field position here as he gets this up over the 40-yard line. Well, this one, partner, was fun down to the very end. They got the points late, right before the whistle. Then the ensuing kickoff, they were hoping for magic on the other side, but couldn't get that spark.
Fun if you won, and fun for us, because we got to watch it and call it. That magic that you were talking about didn't occur in the end, but what a game all the way through.
So for the Seahawks, the win will help them keep pace in the playoff race as they move to 6-3 on the year. And they'll get the weekend off now as they get a little extra time to prepare to face the Atlanta Falcons. Meanwhile, for Arizona, they are barely afloat as they fall to 4-5. And they'll look to regroup next week as they head to Houston to take on the Texans. So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. Good night, everybody.